If you have not subscribed to this channel, press this subscribe button to get subscribed and press this bell icon to get notification as I upload my new video. Shift focus from treatment to prevention. Hello guys, welcoming you all in another episode of Weekly Tech Updates. I am Amit and you are watching Techomed. Guys, hit the like button, it shows me your love towards this channel and keeps me motivated. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. So the update is coming about rapid phone-based tests for multiple infection pathogens. Scientists at University of Illinois and the University of Washington partnered together to develop it. This test is basically deals on detecting the viruses and bacteria which causes disease. It takes about half an hour to give result, which is equivalently accurate as a laboratory test. It consists of a microfluidic chip which contains lamp reagents. Each of this chip parallelly channeled is loaded with reagents designed to react with different nucleic acid sequences. The reagents fluoresces when combined with the right nucleic acid target and illuminates by a specific frequency of light, all embedded on a 3D printed box which is aligned with phone's camera and chip. Just needed a drop of blood and here we can start with it. After 30 minutes, we are done with the desired results. The another tech update is about an electronic pill named ID Cap. These pills are powered by gastric acid to guarantee compliance. This technology is undergoing clinical trials now. A company named etectRx in Newberry, Florida has come out with this. ID Cap uses drug capsules that have a bit of electronics and simple chemistry within them to confirm that a patient truly injected and the pill is ended up in the stomach. The ID Cap is swallowed with the patient's medicine and when it dissolves in the stomach, it sends a very weak radio signal to a small reader that a patient keeps with them. The reader then sends a message to a special app on the patient's smartphone. The app then alerts the patient, pharmacist or physician that the patient has taken the medication. The ID Cap creates a very small amount of power by combining two inert elements with the fluids in your stomach. The only information transferred in this that ID capsule sends a positive signal that indicates ingestion. Let's move on towards the next biotech updates, which is about sound wave short cells, which is used for diagnosis purpose under cell-based therapies. Researchers at the Singapore University of Technology and Design have developed a microfluidic device that can isolate cells from complex biological samples using sound waves. The technique could help doctors to accurately isolate specific type of cells from blood and other bodily fluids, which is useful for diagnosis and cell-based therapies. To separate cells, the biological samples is mixed with a fluorescent labeling molecule which will bind the markers that are specific to cell type of interest. Then the mixture will pass through the microfluidic channel, which is fluorescence detection module detect the labeled cell and activates the sound wave generator that gently detects them into another channel for collection. This sound wave beam has a width of just 50 micrometer and therefore allows for highly accurate sorting down to single cell level. Compared to conventional FSCS systems, the merit of this cell sorting technology includes a substantially simplified sorting mechanism that shrinks the instrument size, reduces its complexity and substantially loses its cost. Not only that, but it also enables more accurate single cell level sorting and leaves no damage on targeting cells because sound waves are much gentler than electric fields. Widely used in the conventional FSCS systems, that's all about this news. That's a sound wave sorting cells. It's a very great initiative done by these guys because it's a very important thing to be at. Having a diagnosis with these cells itself, we have no need to put out the plots in those things like that. The another update is about prosthetics that flexible skin now can sense shear force. Researchers at the University of Washington and University of California have developed a flexible skin Seriously, they have developed a flexible skin that can be applied to a prosthetic limb. The skin can sense vibrations and can also measure shear forces, such as the feeling when your finger slides along a table or an object slips out of your grasp. Now this technology is being done by these guys. Now that robotic technology can feel what exactly the feeling is that human beings are getting while touching something, they can feel the shear by using this shear force technology. So far, artificial skin for prosthetics has not been able to sense a full range of tactile information. Traditionally, tactile sensor design have focused on sensing individual modalities. Now, forces, shear forces, vibrations exclusively. However, dextrose manipulation is a dynamic process that requires a multi-modal approach. But our latest technological skin prototype incorporates all three modalities. It really following the cues of human biology. Our electronic skin blights on one side just like a human finger does the sensor that measures the shear forces and physically located where the enabled would be, which results in a sensor with a similar performance of like a human finger. By mimicking human physiology in a flexible electronic skin, they have created and they have achieved a level of sensitivity and precision that consists the human hand, which is an important breakthrough. The sense of touch is a critically for both prosthetics and robotic applications, and that's what they were ultimately created. It's a very good thing. Moving towards the next update, that is that about precision medicines and artificial intelligence, that there is no precision medicine without artificial intelligence. Moving away from generalized medicine to personalization, we have came through a lot of things and development towards that. Disruptive technologies change that perspective completely. The basis of that transmission is that our physicians are able to collect a vast amount of medical information about the individuals through cheap genome sequencing. Biodata analytics, health sensors, wearable and artificial intelligence. The place of artificial intelligence in precision medicines is very, very, very important, cause big data analytics in one more area where artificial intelligence, especially AI, comes into the picture within a couple of years. It almost probably analyzed big medical data sets, drawn conclusions, find new correlations based on existing precedences and support the doctor's job. Medical limitations and ethical issues around artificial intelligence are increasing and limitations are controlling by them day by day. Medical limitation and ethical issue around artificial intelligence present day has been acknowledged. In the cause of image recognition and using machine learning and deep learning algorithms, for the purpose of radiology, there is risk of feeding the computer not only with the thousands of images but underlying base. For example, the image tends to originate from one part of the US or the framework for conceptualization. The algorithm itself incorporates the subjective assumptions for the working team. Moreover, the forecast and predictive abilities of smart algorithms are anchored in precedence. However, they might be useless in novel cases of drug side effects or treatment resistances. I have no doubt about that. Artificial intelligence will be the stethoscope of the 21st century and the backbone of precision medicine. It has the biggest potential to analyze vast amount of data and offers insight to create personalized solution and targeted treatments. Yet, we have to do everything in our power to ensure that artificial intelligence remains safe, secure and efficiently in fulfilling its mission as the aid of healing patients and helping the medical senses. So that's all about the weekly biotech and tech updates from the Biomedical Society. If you have any query or suggestion, give it in comment section. Like this video, share this video with others. Subscribe to this channel because I used to come up with various tech updates weekly. So this is Amit Mohan Raman signing out. Jai Hind.